Hello everyone, I'm Chester44 and welcome to this Let's Play of Avernum 2. Last episode, we went to Patrick's Tower and took a look around. While finding out about various sorts of things, one of the things we found out about was a special artifact that's apparently located beneath the, beneath Patrick's Tower. I'm going to try to look around to see if anyone might know anything about it. All I was told was that we should start looking around for it in the castle. I'll try talking to the various people. Nothing there. I'll investigate every bookshelf I can see. Do what I can. Doubtful. No, that's... We already know about that, and that's not gonna help. That one was about the portal. That's in there. Wouldn't be in there, that's a kitchen. Wouldn't be in here, well... No, not in here. Can't be in the storerooms. Sorry about that, that was the phone. Okay, anyone else here? Let's see. Ah, one of these bookshelves, maybe? A historical scroll, which we don't need. Let's see, nothing. Historical scroll, nothing. Nothing. Historical scroll, nothing. That led out there. Nothing from her. Really? How are you supposed to find out then? I have no idea. Well, if anyone can give any suggestions, I'll gladly hear them. You? No. Okay, so no bloody idea. Maybe we need to get the royal clearance in order to find out. Okay, so instead, let's take a look around up here. You make your way along the steep slope, which leads up to a broad plateau. The normally humid air of Avernum is exceptionally hot and moist here, and there is a rich, overwhelming sulfur smell. There is a fumarole at the top of this plateau. It is a weak geyser, spouting sulfur steam. The ground is caked with yellow mineral deposits. It is not a pleasant place. Your eyes start to water. In the middle of this hellish, sulfurous landscape, you have found a small, cozy hut. There is a garden of sickly mushrooms in front. Knock on the door. After a pause, the door is opened by a woman with black robes. She's not very old, but her long hair is snowy white. She has the sickly white skin of one who has spent most of her life in the underworld. She smiles and says, "Welcome, would you like to come in?" She seems friendly, but it could be a trap. "We'll walk in." She lets you in. "Welcome, travelers. I have heard of you. Roan of the castle has told me of your deeds. I am Silverlock. I live up here so I can watch the plains below and work in peace." She makes you fungus tea and you talk. You tell her of your travels and of the Venati, and she tells you how she makes wonderful potions with an amazing variety of powers. When your tea is finished, you get up to leave. Silverlock says, "Before you go, would you like to purchase some of my potions?" Silverlock begins to pull out boxes of potions, but then she stops to think. "My potions are very powerful and rare. I wouldn't sell them to anyone who I wasn't convinced was of the highest character. Perhaps you should go and do good a bit more. If additional word of your good deeds reaches me, I would be happy to help you." So I guess we need more reputation. A pity. Alright, let's look around some more. Ah, is this Fort Emerald to the north? I think it is. Yes, that's Fort Emerald, which means the Slith City should also be nearby. There's a heavy stone sign by the road. Castle 60 miles east, Patrick's Tower 130 miles south, Darmon 80 miles west. Now what the hell, we can go into the fort. we can explore what we can. Bit of trash out here. I do find that little bug there odd. Well, here's the fort. A long, crude barricade has been erected to either side of the fort in case a flanking attack comes over the water. Small openings have been placed in the barrier with deadfalls suspended near them so that they can be closed quickly in an attack. Which makes perfect sense. Hello there. You meet another mage of Avernum. His robes have been charred recently, probably by a stray spell. He's looking at a magical barrier, trying to figure out what to do with it. He turns and nods at you.
I am Hustus. Greetings.
What are you working on?
I am currently dispelling some barriers. It needs doing sometimes when we want to build a wall somewhere and the fields we put up to repair things are in the way. It's tedious, but it's my responsibility.
What did you do before the war?
Before I joined up to fight the war, I was doing research at the Tower of Magi.
Seems a long time ago.
What research were you involved with? I was trying to create a spell to scry large areas of the outdoor, much as magic maps small areas, such as towns. Alas, a spell to see a large area is a terribly difficult thing to create, and even harder to summon up the energy to cast. I believe that someone has figured out how to do this. I've heard rumors, but I don't know if it is actually possible.
Hustus continues to ponder the barrier. Occasionally, he pokes at it with his fingers.
Excuse my ignoring you. Testing these things is my job.
Can you teach us how to dispel barriers?
Sadly, no. I'm under strict orders not to teach adventurers anything useful without permission from General Landrin. You should talk to him.
That's stupid. We're on the same side.
Perhaps, but we've had a terrible time getting supplies and help. We've had to trade for most of what we need. I think the General wants to trade my knowledge for your help. Look at it from our point of view. We have a job, and Avernum needs us to do it. This is what it takes. Well, there you go.
This short stairway leads up to the ramparts of the fort. Okay, well, I suppose he did make sense there. This woman is staring intently over the barricade, watching carefully for attackers. She wears mage's robes and she seems ready to fling a spell at any moment. She nods when you approach, not looking away from the blasted ground outside.
I am Silverio.
What are you looking for?
She makes a soft shushing noise.
Shh.
Quiet. I'm watching for an attack.
Is an attack imminent?
She speaks quickly and quietly, never averting her eyes.
That's just it. We don't know. We never know. We all take shifts watching for Empire raids. They can conceal themselves magically. They can appear in seconds, throw a few balls of fire, and get away. We then have very little time to strike back.
How do you repair the walls?
We have to plug any holes in the walls with magic barriers before any attackers can climb through them. The barriers are our most powerful defense.
How so?
Even when the enemy smashes a hole in our defenses, we can plug it up right away. Without that ability, this fort would have fallen long ago.
Pots of boiling oil are kept here at all times. In case of an attack, they can easily be poured into the passage below.
This chilly chamber is where the bodies of Avernite soldiers are kept before being taken to be buried. Their weapons have been laid reverently at their feet, and pieces of fabric embroidered with the sun symbol of Avernum have been placed on their faces.
We'll leave them to that. That's the way out. I don't think we'll be going out there. We'll leave that lever there. That looks like a captain.
General! General Landrin. A strong, weathered man stares intently out the window, watching for movements. He wears the insignia of a general. As he speaks, he doesn't look away from the window.
I am General Landrin. Landrin, welcome to my fort.
Are you the field commander out here?
He nods, not looking away from the uncontrolled territory to the north.
Yes, I lead all the troops in this area.
Oh really? Not just the fort?
All Avernite forces within 50 miles get their orders from this fort. My fort.
He smiles briefly in pride, but he doesn't stop watching the window.
And my responsibility. We face a difficult enemy.
Who is your enemy?
I am fighting Limoncelli of Fort Dolthar. He is the Empire commander and a deadly vicious warrior and my sworn enemy. If any adventurers were willing to undertake a mission to deal with this menace, I would reward them.
What do you know about this Limoncelli?
Limoncelli is my opposite number, the commander of all the enemy in this area. He lives in Fort Dolthar, a huge fort on an island to the northeast where the Slith Lord Sisthis used to live. And he's really, really smart. It's been all we could do to keep him from destroying us, but we'll beat him yet.
We will undertake the mission to Fort Dolthar for you. Can you give me any more details?
I want you to go kill Limoncelli. Find a way to Fort Dalthar, get in, and slay him. Do it, and not only will I try to give you to get you a promotion, but I'll tell one of my mages to give you the Dispel Barrier spell. And that ain't easy to get.
We're gonna have to complete that as soon as we can, then. General Landrin grunts quietly. You aren't sure whether he's trying to indicate that you should ask him something else, or that you should go away.
What are you looking for?
He points north.
Out there? Empire territory. We're on the border right now. They don't have strong control of the caves to the north, but they have enough. You want to go out there, watch out. Oh, and a warning.
What warning?
If you leave this fort to the north, you likely won't be able to return this way. The Empire enemy can disguise themselves magically, so we won't open the gates for you, because it might not be you.
Right then, we will not enter the path to the north. No, I'm not trying to jump off. And that's just a place where they eat. Okay, nothing over there. Nothing over here. A small shrine has been placed at the base of this wall. It's surrounded by many small modest offerings, both in memory of soldiers and friends lost and in supplication for a safe future. Right then, time to explore around this place. Chamber of the Crystal.
Alright, that was why this place is Fort Emerald.
You meet a priest in white robes. He's staring into a large green crystal and meditating. He's a middle-aged man with very sparse hair.
I'm Buck. Welcome to the fort.
What are you doing?
I'm doing my meditations. Then I will return to my healing.
Ah, you're the fort's healer.
One of them. When an attack comes, a lot of people become hurt very quickly, and I need to move fast and work hard. That's why I keep as much energy stored up as I possibly can at all times.
How do you meditate?
He points at the green crystal which dominates the room.
We don't know where it came from or who made it, but it regenerates our magical power very quickly.
You should try it. It's a wonderful sensation. It's an amazing crystal. We wish we knew who made it.
It's very strange sometimes, though.
How is it strange?
He looks nervous.
I don't like to talk about it, and people laugh at me for saying it, but sometimes... Sometimes when I feel the energy from the crystal, I almost think it's trying to talk to me.
Just the stress of the war, I'm sure.
Crystal looks like it was made by the Venati.
Was it? Interesting. And frightening. We'll keep using it, I think, but we'll be a lot more careful about it.
He leans back from the crystal, highly relaxed, and turns to you.
I can talk while I use this thing. If there's anything else you want to know, fire away.
You heal the soldiers when they get wounded?
Not quite. I heal the soldiers I can. When I run out of energy, all I can do is sit back and watch them die. And who heals me when I'm grievously wounded? We need more priests, but we're not getting them.
Can you heal us?
He can, but we have no need for the healing.
We do have stuff that needs to be sold, though.
A minuscule woman in loose clothes sits cross-legged on her chair, staring into the glowing green crystal. Her gaze flickers up to you for a moment.
I am Tessa. What brings you here, strangers?
What are you doing?
Preparing for my next raid. Move fast, strike hard, that sort of thing. We're heading north.
What are you going to raid?
There's an Empire fort being built in the north, then a ways to the northwest. A ways on the other side of this huge rubble-strewn cave. We're trying to disrupt things and maybe come up with a pass.
Do you think you can stop them?
Nah, we can't keep them from building a fortress that far back, but we can certainly slow things down. Harass them, you know.
What pass?
We've been trying to get our hands on a blue pass, you know? The pass the Empire folks used to get places. They've been having lots of supplies shipped into the new fort, so we think they must have some passes there.
She focuses into the crystal.
But it's very dangerous, and I need all the power I can get.
This dome's sole source of light is a large green crystal. It rests on a pedestal in the center of the room. It glows from within, sending out a warm, constant beam of energy. The crystal is large, fragile, and surrounded by several chairs and kneeling pads. They seem to be there so that you can meditate while staring deep within the magical stone. Looking at the crystal, you can see that it is a Venati creation. It's just too much like their crystals to ignore the resemblance. Its origin has been a mystery for years. Now, at last, you know who made it. Let us meditate.
You kneel before the crystal and feel its energy flowing into you. Your magical energy is restored.
Excellent.
There is only one soldier in this infirmary. He's sitting in the back. He's horribly wounded.
This man has taken a nasty wound recently. His ribs are wrapped in a broad gauze bandage, and you can see that the blood is slowly starting to seep through. He looks up at you and groans.
I'm Brian. What do you want?
How did you wind up like this? He starts to sit up, winces in pain, and lies back down.
I was doing some recon, that's how I ended up this way.
Recon?
Reconnaissance, spying, watching the enemy. Real risky. See, my patrol was on a boat trip up northeast, and when we landed, we got ambushed.
Ambushed by who?
Empire soldiers. They're all dead now, but one of them got me across the ribs with his sword. I'll be okay, I hope. Better off than him, anyway.
He touches the bandage gingerly, then winces.
You know what burns my butt? I say what I saw in my recon, and nobody believes me. Nobody!
What did you see?
Yeah, see, we brushed near Lumencelli's fort to take a look, and I saw a bunch of those tall, skinny, weird guys landing in a boat. Those weird guys were the barriers. What were they called?
Venati?
Yeah, those freaks. Saw a bunch of them talking with Lumencelli's troops right outside his fort. I don't know why they'd be there, but I don't trust them.
Brian looks up at you, but he doesn't try to say anything. Understandable. Even with magical healing available, someone with this grievous a wound needs to conserve his strength. How are you doing?
Not getting better. The priests here just aren't strong enough to help. I'll try to pull through, but, well.
The Venati talking with... Oh, that is very concerning. You meet a captain of the Avernum army. When he sees you, he walks over to greet you.
Welcome to our fort adventures. I am Captain Schnitzius. Welcome. Nice to see new faces, especially when they're adventurers. We can always use adventurers.
Thanks. Busy?
I'm preparing for another raid. That's what I do, mainly.
Tell us about the raids.
We're all fighting the army of Lumencelli here. He's a very nasty and cunning Empire commander. Soon I'll be off on another raid to try to penetrate his defenses.
Not optimistic. Where is Lumencelli's army?
He lives in Fort Dolthar on an island to the northeast and runs all his raids from there. We're just trying to find a way to get at him.
He pauses, then continues grimly.
Of course, even if we did reach him, he's a... an unusual warrior.
In what way?
I don't know how much of this is rumors and how much is fact, but he's...
he's magical. He's fast. He moves faster than a hasted person, and he's that way all the time. I don't know how he got that way, but let me tell you, it doesn't make me too happy about the idea of fighting him.
Keep that in mind.
Captain Schnitzius waits patiently to see if there's anything else you need.
Eager to serve, always like to help adventurers.
Seen lots of action?
You don't know the half of it. Hardly a day goes by when some Empire soldiers don't sneak up and throw a few fireballs. They hope to get a lucky kill on us. Sometimes they succeed.
But it's the Empire. Why don't they just overwhelm you with their huge armies?
Because those armies are on the surface, not down here. And they're likely to stay that way. It's hard to teleport lots of people down here. That's been the only thing that's saved our lives.
Do you need any jobs done?
Yes, 1,000 times yes. If you could kill Lumencelli, I could give you a reward. We keep sending out raids, but we never get him. If you're interested, go speak with General Landrin. He's on the north wall.
Tell us about the raids.
We're all fighting the army of Lumencelli here. He's a very nasty and cunning Empire commander. Soon I'll be off on another raid to try to penetrate its defenses. I'm not optimistic.
Where is Lumencelli's army?
We already know that.
What sort of reward would you give us for killing Lumencelli?
Well, one of the hardest spells to learn, as I understand it, is the spell Barrier. If you could help us with this little task, I'm sure General Landrin could see it clear to help you get this valuable and much-in-demand spell.
Thank you. We'll definitely keep that in mind. Looks like there's a hidden room back here. In this cramped, concealed back room, you find a small cell. The rank smell and the claw marks on the walls and floor indicate that, for whatever reason, a monster is being stored here.
Ooh.
Well, let's see what it is. Pick the lock. A chit rack? Why did they have a chit rack back here? Let's see. Who are you? You meet a young merchant wearing rough clothes and an equally rough expression. She nods briefly to you.
Call me Theresa. What do you want?
We're looking for information, mostly.
I'm a merchant, see, and I'm waiting for my current shipment to be approved so I can head out.
You're a merchant?
Yeah, what of it? Do
Tough work traveling in these times.
What's in your shipment?
400 pounds of iron rats for Fort Emerald. Then on to Darman.
She says the word Darman with a great lack of enthusiasm.
Not looking forward to Darman, eh?
Yeah, Darman, westernmost city of Avernum and city nearest to where all the real bloodshed is going on. I gotta take a load there and then I'm getting back east where it's safe.
Nowhere is safe from the Empire.
Well, safer anyway.
Theresa stares at you impatiently. She seems to wish she could go back to her work. Something is definitely bothering her.
Still here? What do you want?
Why are you upset?
I fell for someone I shouldn't. A soldier here named Brian. Now he's hurt, wounded. The priest can't do anything for him. I can't help him. Nobody can. It's driving me mad.
She closes her mouth, embarrassed that she said so much.
Can you sell us anything?
No, I can't. My goods are supposed to go to regular soldiers and regular forts. Sorry.
It's the least sincere apology you've ever heard.
Storage for various things there. Looks like there may be another cell here.
That looks like a fire lizard.
And it was!
Why are they storing lizards and creatures in these cells?
Fort Emerald HQ, Commander General Landrin. Well, we've already spoken with General Landrin.
Pants and tunics, pants and shirt, silver coins here.
Nothing and nothing.
And in here, the barracks.
Alright, I think that's going to be all we're going to take a look at here.
There we go. Alright, let's take a look out here a bit more.
You meet a patrol of Avernum soldiers. Seeing them, you mainly feel relief that such grunt work has been left behind you. Being a hero is dangerous, true, but there's a lot to be said for the lack of tedium.
Yes, I can imagine. Well, there's some things here. Watchtower.
You meet patrol of same thing.
Farms and the like up here, and there's Blosk. And that must be Ness.
You meet a group of ragged refugees. There are 12 of them, mostly men, all very tired and hungry. They shuffle forward, eyes on the ground, and try to avoid you.
Approach and talk to them?
You speak with them for a while. They seem reluctant to talk to an Avernite, and you soon learn why. They're refugees from the Abyss. The Abyss was where Avernum sent people who were petty criminals or too rebellious to fit in. When the Empire invaded Avernum, the Abyss was the first place to fall, and the people who escaped alive went to Avernum, where they weren't at all welcome. One man speaks with you while the others hang back.
Now we're poor and wandering around. We don't want to depend on you Avernum people's mercy, but we got no choice. You spare a few coins?
You do know that there is a colony of Abyss refugees to the east of here?
The man seems surprised. They clearly haven't heard about the refugee camp.
Our own kind? Together? That sounds a lot better than wandering around. Thanks for telling us.
Feeling a touch of hope at last, the refugees start marching east as fast as their exhaustion allows.
And our reputation increased.
There is a heavy barricade barring this route, guarded with a powerful-looking garrison of sliths, hundreds of them with plenty of magic. They nod to you politely as they let you pass, but are wary of speaking with you. And that leads north into Empire-controlled lands. We're not dealing with that. Not now, anyway.
There are two tiny fishing villages on this island. One is mainly populated by humans, and the other is settled by sliths. They mostly seem to keep to themselves, but the relations between them are clearly cordial.
Okay, then. I'm just curious whether reaching 40 reputation is enough to,
No, it is not. Maybe we need to get 50 or something.
Ah, well.
Well, we got Blosk and Nass here, so... Next episode. Next episode, we'll go into Nass and speak with the Sliths. See what we can find out from them. Till then, I'm Chester44, that is Rex, Scary, Talia, and Leah. This has been an Avernum 2 Let's Play, and I shall see you all next time.